This is going to be a really quick review. Eurovision Song Contest, the story of Fire Saga, stars Will Ferrell as Lars Eriksson, an Icelandic singer with the dreams to be entered and to win the Eurovision Song Contest. Now, for those who don't know what Eurovision is, it's a European song contest held every year, bar 2020, for obvious reasons, where different EU countries send their best musical acts to go and compete to win the contest for glory for their country! We sing better than you! The only thing bringing Lars down is that in his town, he's known as kind of like the town fool. People don't take him seriously. He's kind of the joke of the town, except for his one female friend who's been with him since childhood. And together, they, through a lot of luck, end up qualifying for Eurovision and now are the underdog, the dark horse, in said competition, where their relationship gets torn and they must somehow stick together to win this contest. Now, first, I just want to say, after watching Carolyn Tuesday recently and realizing that I grew up watching American Idol, I have a soft spot for these kind of stories. I have a soft spot for musical contests where the characters must come together to overcome the odds and they become closer along the way and all that cheesy shit. I love it. It's a guilty pleasure of mine. And towards the end of this film, when the contest really, really heats up, the last couple performances by our main duo are good. I really enjoyed the ending of the movie. The end of this movie where all the pieces come together and the performances are awesome, they're heartfelt. I really like it. The problem is we're talking about a comedy. Now I will say, as a comedy, this movie fails. I chuckled 3 times, mainly over jokes making fun of Americans, because as a Canadian, we're close enough to Europe to be able to make those jokes. So they're funny to me, even though they weren't like haha funny, it was more like stupid American. That's it. So I will say, as a comedy, this movie fails. It's basically, if you've seen a Will Ferrell movie before, it's a Will Ferrell movie. He does a lot of I'm silly comedy. He does a lot of I'm a grown man acting like a little kid comedy. And unfortunately, Rachel McAdams, who I love, she's great in this movie, but man, fall from grace compared to The Notebook, I'm sorry. Again, like, a lot of actors who work with Will Ferrell end up having to eventually take up that mantle where they have to do the same, look at me, I'm silly kind of comedy, and unfortunately she was, a lot of her good scenes end with her kind of really committing to that kind of comedy, which again, it could just be like a personal thing for me, but I'm really not into it. And even though she has some of the best scenes, some of the best moments in the film, those silly moments just tear me out of it. And I know it's a comedy and comedy's subjective. You might like what I don't, but after years of watching these movies, I have a younger brother who's like obsessed with Will Ferrell. He loves him. I've tried. I just can't get into it. The only Will Ferrell movie I ever really got into was Blades of Glory, and I was like 12 when I watched it. And there's not really any profound comedy in this movie. There's a lot of jokes. There's a, oh, is this character gay joke? Ooh, but honestly, this movie is very not funny. Very unfunny. Now, as I said at the beginning, there is enjoyment to be had. If you're like me and you like song contests and stuff, there's a bit of cliche drama, which again, guilty pleasure of mine, that I'm into, and some of the songs are good, but as this isn't necessarily a musical, but there are a lot of musical numbers, and they're like rehearsals, and a part of the movie where they just all break out into like a mashup of ABBA songs and all that stuff, which should have been a scene for someone like me, except I realized, again, I know a lot of these scenes are lip-synced, because you can't really do them live, but man, it's so obvious that this stuff is lip-synced. Like, there's some actors where, like, you can tell the syncing's off, and in a... This is a Netflix original. I have certain standards for what Netflix does on their platform. This ain't it. And another thing, talking about, like, the music throughout the film, a lot of it just seems like they're going for kind of humorous undertones, which take away from the performances. If you're watching this to watch performances and like good musical numbers, you're not really gonna get it here. Besides a few at the end, particularly the last one by Fire Saga is good, but honestly, and again, this is why I said at the beginning it's gonna be a quick review, because normally I'd be a lot more critical, be like, I break down the film, but this is honestly a train wreck of a movie in my opinion. There's not really much to critique, there's not really much to talk about, besides this is a comedy that's not funny, the music segments aren't engaging, barred a few, and honestly, Will Ferrell just seems like, I know they picked him because it's Will Ferrell, he has the star power, but he looks out of place in this cast, and I know that's the point. Will Ferrell's supposed to stand out, he's supposed to be like, oh look, it's a Will Ferrell movie, everyone's much younger than him, and of course he ends up with a girl like 20 years younger than him, because that's a Will Ferrell movie, but it really doesn't fit here. And also, his accent drops throughout the movie. He has this really horrible Icelandic accent that from the first scene he was in threw me off, and he drops it at least twice that I saw in the movie. Once, like, blatantly, like, why did they not reshoot that scene? It's so blatant that he drops the accent. Like, I know it's just a quick line, but it's so, like, 2 seconds on screen where I'm like, he broke accent. Which, again, some of the editing in this movie just seems sloppy. This just seems like, let's put Will Ferrell in a comedy, put it on Netflix, people will watch it. And, hey, I watched it, so I guess it kind of it worked, but honestly, final verdict, don't watch this movie. Even if you're really into, like, musicals, or you're really into, like, musical performance movies, if that makes sense, there's a lot better stuff on Netflix in particular to watch that's not this. If you're looking for a comedy, there's a lot better stuff than this on Netflix. Anyway, sorry for the very pessimistic review. I know this is a very jumbled one, but I was just flabbergasted what to say with this one. And with that being said, I've been Benny B. You've been awesome, and shave your head. Back to back,